The Jesuits also went to Japan as early as 1549, also adopted the silk dress of the Japanese. By 1601, there were native Japanese pastors. These are people that were actually Japanese, born and raised in Japan, knew the language and the culture from birth. They became committed Christian missionaries and pastors. As a result, it's estimated that the Japanese mission had hundreds of thousands of Christians by the early 1600s. However, it would come to an end largely because the Dutch and the English, seeing a problem with the Jesuits actually making the Japanese too independent and making them less easy to be exploited, convinced the Japanese the Jesuits were there to conquer their country. As a result, the Japanese throughout time would persecute the Jesuits and would also persecute Japanese Christians, often crucifying them, a method that they curiously learned from the gospel story. What's curious, though, is that the Japanese Christians managed to survive. In fact, the Jesuits have come back time and time again, always bringing their message with them. And the Christians actually managed to survive, especially in the great Japanese city of Nagasaki. That is, until 1945, when we dropped an atomic bomb upon that city, ending what was probably the remaining Christian community in that area. So I think it's another story altogether.